withdrawn. Now, there are also contradicting reports as to what causes the damage. The U.S. military says limpet mines caused the damage, which were attached to the hull of the ship. But the Japanese owner, the Kokura Courageous, cast doubt on part of the U.S. narrative, saying that the vessel's crew saw flying objects before the blast, calling reports of a mine attack false, and saying that the crew, that they're dismissing any reports that a bomb was attached to the side of the ship. So things are still very murky, and I don't think we know exactly what's going on until the results of an investigation are given to us.
Thank you very much. I'll be with you at this morning. General, let me go to you first. A couple of people in the New York Times this morning about this incident we've attached. We're going to put the challenges of diplomatic and economic, as well as military. And in another piece, I point out there's a deep distrust of the American administration that was pulled out of the Iran nuclear war, spurring its European allies and showing suspicion that the United States is falling into a fight with Iran. That's where I want to go with you. Gavin, when you hear about the U.S. left that deal, what's your sense of how European allies are looking at things like the video that the Pentagon came out yesterday?
They think that they are living in a crisis of American influence, not Iran. A year ago, Trump pulled out the Iran nuclear. By the way, having lied about it, having said that Iran wasn't complying when the UN agency was talking about the Iran war. So again, here we are on the precipice of a potential war, and why didn't the press doesn't come? Ever since we pulled out of that deal, they've stacked on provocations coming in from us towards Iran. They're stacking up sanctions, designating the Iranian Revolutionary Guard as a terrorist organization. Rhetoric would suggest we're going to hold Iran accountable for anything any of the proxies do in the region, even though they have any control over some of those proxies in the Middle East. To me, it has felt like, and I think the Europeans have felt like, the Trump administration has been bullying Iran into doing something that could then give the Trump administration a pretext to go to war. And so this is exactly the kind of scenario that the Europeans are doing.